At what point do you give up? At what point do you admit that something is not worth your time? In games, movies, and anime, there are certain unspoken rules of when you can abandon something and still have a valid opinion on it. There's a 3-episode rule for anime. I don't think there's like necessarily a universal rule for games, but usually it's like a third of the way through is when you can quit a game and still have a valid opinion on it. And for movies, they tell you to watch the whole thing. I'll be damned if I am watching a whole boring ass movie just for shits and giggles. If it's boring, I'm walking out the theater. I'm hitting the pause button. I'm not sitting there and watching the whole thing. You got me fucked up. And then you say my opinion on the movie isn't valid because I didn't watch the whole thing. If the shit's so ass that I can't finish it, then it's ass. And these rules are fine and all, and they make sense to a certain degree. But what I don't like is how these rules get thrown out the window whenever there's something that a lot of niggas like, but it takes a lot longer to get good. Time is a precious resource in this life, and you can only do so many things with the time you're given. So why do people constantly urge you to waste your time? Every time the same argument is brought up, One Piece, Hunter x Hunter, Gintama, Final Fantasy, Xenoblade, all these long ass movies, shows, and games, and they like, everybody you say you don't like them, they're like, nah, but hold on, it gets better. I don't wanna wait for later. 1,000 episodes? When does it get good? Nigga said 264. 264. What? Who do you think I am, the Lord of Time? 25 minutes, 264 episodes. 25 minutes times 264 is 6,600 minutes. 110 hours. 110 hours of mediocrity. I'm not watching it. And then there are games like Xenoblade. I get that it's a story-based game. I love story-based game. I literally play games like Quarry and visual novels like Danganronpa. So I consider myself pretty patient when it comes to story-based games. But Xenoblade is just too slow. I played Xenoblade 2 and I hated it. I heard that Xenoblade 3 was better and I gave it the benefit of the doubt. But what the fuck? A 30-hour tutorial, like, give or take, I don't know if I'm just a slow-ass nigga, but that's a long time to go before you unlock all the features of a damn game. 30 hours! That's the full length of most games. You can't be serious. I also played the Final Fantasy VII Remake. I played like a good 3/4 of it from what I heard. And when I was talking to a coworker about how I wasn't really happy with the game, he said, oh, no, this is just the first part. The second part is where it really gets good. Nigga, what do you mean the second part's where it really gets good? So you're telling me I gotta play a whole game that's mediocre just to get to the good part? That's a waste of damn time! If you want a good example of something that gets good, Attack on Titan is a great example. It takes about like 10 episodes, and then after that, it's uphill. Some would argue that it takes even less than that. And then there's like, what, like 50 or so episodes of Attack on Titan off the top of my head that I can think of. That's a very small percentage of the show that is born. And then we have Clannad Meat Riders. 35 to 40-ish episodes of boring shit, just boring nonsense. They admit it.
For sure. Yeah. And I think the whole time when I was watching Clannad, I'm like, when's it gonna get good? Yeah.
But then they stick around for the last 10 episodes. The last 10 episodes, you expect me to watch 40 episodes, which I did, by the way, just for 10 episodes of stuff that's good, and then the shit that they say was good wasn't even that good. And you're probably sitting there thinking I'm overreacting about this shit. But like, think about it this way. You're sinking hundreds of hours, potentially, into these forms of media. And towards where it gets good, you might find that the show isn't even your type of show, and it never got good. And your friend that just loved it convinced you to watch this, and at the end, you feel like you wasted your time. That's the problem with the it gets good sentiment. Even if I'm guaranteed to like it after a certain point, is it really worth sitting through boredom for a good majority of the time? 200 episodes! And I'm not gonna lie, I've said the it gets good shit to some niggas too, but that's usually with shorter stuff. It's usually like 10 episodes, 20 maximum. 20 episodes maximum is what I'll recommend when it gets good later. Or if it's a game, maybe 5 hours into the game maximum. I don't want niggas wasting their time, especially because that reduces the credibility of my recommendations. I'm just fed up with niggas invalidating my experience because I didn't get to the good part. It's that show, game, or movie's fault if it wasn't good enough to keep my attention. It's not my responsibility to play a game to its completion just to make you feel better, nigga. I'm not a critic. But leave a like if you enjoyed. I just really had to say something about it because I had a whole debate about it with a nigga the other day, and it was just fresh on my mind, and I thought I'd make a good video. Share with the homies. So yeah, again, leave a like if you enjoyed the video so people can see it. Comment your thoughts. Y'all stay blessed and have a good one.